Damn. Shit, now.
Sit back and just watch us bubble. Gorillas out of the concrete jungle. We come with more heat.
Shit, now.
You guys know what Kendra Vidara is, right? There's some rich people like, what is this, a spa? You guys, it's a government school. It barely qualifies as a school. Barely. Like, they have rooms that resemble classrooms. Oh, man. Yeah, so we had a lovely curriculum in KV called CBSE. It's so depressing, CBSE. That the only thing we look forward to is discussing marks. See, like people show off like, hey bro, I got 88%. Like, yeah, I got 90%, bro. And one person like, I got 94. Got 94? Yeah, I do state syllabus. Hey, state! Get out, man! And then one guy will come and be like, I got 95, I do ICC. Oh, yo, go buy it. Okay, thank you, we'll leave. We will pay for your bill, just... ICSE, who did ICSE? Oh my god, you guys are sorted for life, okay? While we were learning addition and subtraction, you were learning how to send Mars rovers. I don't know, what retarded curriculum they have. Oh my god, scary. And obviously, in KV, they do a lot of torture techniques to slowly break you down as a child. The first thing is called morning assembly. Morning assembly is this phenomena where you put kids in the sun, roast them to light medium brown. Make sure they turn brown. And they make the guys stand in ascending order of insecurities. Shortest, least self-confident guy goes in the first. Genetically gifted, tall guy who's good looking will do well in life in the back. If you're gonna play with them, make a stand and decline, no. Hey, you're so small, yeah, correct, sorry. While you're at it, just. They make sure that everyone does not have a sense of individualism. They're making sure everybody wears the same uniform. And there's the wicked Death Eater of the morning assembly, the person who checks if you're wearing a uniform correctly. That asshole. No kid should be given so much power. They're just like, oh, macha, I'm not wearing the belt. Don't worry, just pull your shirt like this. He'll never check. Yeah, no, I'll just pull it like this, he won't check. And suddenly he goes and he's like, he fucking ridiculous, go like, oh, he'll pass you and like, and then you stop. I love the pledge. We used to always wait for someone to screw it up. India is my country. Yeah, keep going. You fuck up. 10 rupees bol raha, he'll break in the middle. All Africans are my brothers. See, he screwed it up. No one got it right. I still can't get it right. Like, I heard it every day for 12 years. And then, yeah, so there are torture techniques that teachers use. So there was this teacher called Prasad sir. I still call him sir because I'm afraid he'll come and hit me from somewhere. Just check if he's not here. Because Prasad sir used to do this thing. So there's a proper Heil Hitler thing in school. You just, good morning, teacher. After a point, it wasn't about respect anymore. Like, don't hit me, teacher. So Prasad sir, you obviously had a nickname. Every teacher has a nickname, right? So you can't respect it. Only when I grew up, I realized how tough it is to be a teacher. But let's go back to as a kid. So Prasad sir, we used to call him James Bond. Because he used to wear shades. And he used to have like slick back hair, full perfectly gelled. I think he gelled with the tears of the children. Just freshly gelled. And he used to try to catch us. Like, we didn't even like mess up. He used to make sure we mess up. So he used to like enter suddenly into the room and all of us will be caught by surprise and someone who's not standing will get caught. So what we used to do, in the between the class, we have 5 minutes of like freedom, right? Of just pure freedom. Teacher leaves like, we're just chilling. And all of us are smart. Like, we used to keep one leg distance from our desk. We used to chill like this. Teacher comes to me, good morning, sir. So we're prepared. But there'll be one, two idiots who like in the back are like, and suddenly teacher comes in like, and Prasad sir used to like, he was a cold-blooded killer. He used to like, Kenny, stand. Make Arjun also stand.
Sir, Arjun ne kuch nahi kiya, sir.
Why are you bringing him to this? You want me? Go after me. So Arjun and me are standing. And now his weapon of choice was the duster. All you rich folks will be like, oh, what's a big deal with a duster, Kenny? A duster in Kendriya Vidyalaya. I'm just thinking, if I was a duster manufacturer, what is the material I would use? When I know the duster is going to be around children. I'm sure they had a board meeting, right? They would have discussed this, right? So what do you think we should use for the duster? I don't know, you recommend. Wooden nails? Perfect, let's manufacture it for all the Kendriya Vidyalayas. So Prasad sir took that duster and he's about to throw it at me. And Arjun started shivering because Prasad sir has bad aim. Arjun is like, I'm like, He takes the duster, throws it, obviously hits Arjun, but I have to react. I'm like, oh, I can totally imagine how that feels. Don't throw it again. I think the worst thing about that getting punished was exams, man. I just don't know why we did exams. I don't see the purpose of it, but it is important, children. It is important. Exams are important. If you don't do well in exams, you'll end up like me. Happy. So don't. Don't do exams. So, in all like some eighth fail or anything, I have an undergrad, okay? Don't worry. I have a degree in painting, okay? It's a degree. It's a degree, physics girl. Organic chemistry masters. It is a degree. I painted for 4 years and did sculpture, okay? It's cool. The only thing I learned from painting college is all the paintings are contemporary. Just that's it. That's the secret. You go to art museum, you don't know what to say. Contemporary, like it. It's all it. So anyway, worst thing was exams. Because in exams anyway, you know you're gonna fail, right? And you study, but you write the exam and you come back home and your parents are so sweet, they really care. They're like, how was the exam? Oh, fantastic. I think I'll get 95. Maybe I'll lose one mark for handwriting. I don't know, chill. And then you get the paper and obviously like I got 14 or something. And I'm coming to terms with it. I'm coming to terms with it and I'm like, okay, got 14. Probably get slapped once or twice. It's okay, it's cool. You can manage it. Just work harder for the next one. And then the teacher gives you this false sense of hope. If there are any calculation mistakes. And I have the audacity to go compare my paper with the class topper. Bro, give your paper, Nada. How was your 95? What do I have? Hey, same only, da. Only last answer is wrong. At least you should get 7 marks for method, no? So go back to the teacher and he puts you in your locker. Like, sir, I have to get 2 marks for what? Sir, I have to get 5 more marks, eh? Take this paper, put up your ass and fuck off. And then, the hottest girl in class goes up to the teacher and this weird thing happens. I just look back to it now and it is pretty weird. It's like, sir, I got 98. I need to get 1 more mark, sir. So, that's when I realized what sexual tension was. I was like, why is the room getting so hot suddenly? And so used to give it. It was so creepy. He's a middle-aged man. So next time when I went for a date, I was like, hey, Kenny. I'm like, oh, calculation mistake.
Sit back and just watch us bubble. Gorillas out of the concrete jungle. We come with more heat. Sit down.